Take a second to introduce ourselves before we get started with the rest of our program. I'm from Washington State. My name is Andrew Faulkner, and I'm a junior down at the college, and I'm studying business management.
Hello, everyone. I'm all the way from South Korea. My name is Yesung Kim. If you guys can't really remember that, just call me Carl. I won't be offended. I'm currently going into my junior year, and I'm studying music education.
Hello, everybody. My name is Stephen Roy. I am a junior business management major at the college, and I am from the very hot and dry city of Phoenix, Arizona.
Good evening, everybody. I'm from Tampa, Florida. My name is Titus Moore, and I'm getting ready to start my sophomore year at the college, and I'm studying cybersecurity.
My name is Blake Adams. I am from Louisville, Kentucky, and I'm a sophomore studying criminal justice. You know, there's a lot right now that's going on in our country that can cause us all to have distress or worry. But as Christians, we have the distinct and unique privilege of having Jesus Christ as our Savior. And when you think about what he's done for us, when he came from heaven and died on the cross for our sins, that distress and worry and everything that's going on can just seem to fade away. Just think back to the last time that you just sat down and thought about what Jesus did. And if you haven't fully heard of the good news of the gospel, listen to this next song as we sing at Calvary, and just let it open your heart to God's amazing love.
Years I
So in light of that, I just want to share my salvation testimony with you guys real quick. My story starts at about 7 years old. I was raised in a Christian home. I was taught the Bible from a very early age. And I made a profession of faith when I was seven. And I did so mostly because my parents, I knew my parents would be happy with me if I did. I knew that my pastor would be happy and my church would, you know, they would all be glad. So it was more for their sakes than for mine. And knowing that I had accepted Christ into my heart. So as I grew older, I started more and more losing that faith and began to doubt more my security in Christ. And that was because I believe I was trusting in works. I was trusting in how good I was inherently to save me. And that didn't stop. The doubts continued to escalate and the faith continued to decline until I was about 13 years old. And an evangelist came to my church, and he talked about the sufficiency of Christ's sacrifice on the cross. He talked about how for every Christian, even on their worst day, Christ's sacrifice paid the penalty for all their sin, and we can live in communion with God we can have that relationship with God, and we can have it restored because of what Christ has done on the cross. It's not about how good we are or how worthy we are to be loved or saved by God, because we're not. But it's all about what Christ did for us on our behalf, so that we may trust in Him and give all the glory to Him for saving us. And that's when I really placed my faith in Christ and had that confidence. And I carry it to this day, where it's not about me. It's all about what He did, His sacrifice, His penalty. And that's how I came to know Christ as my Savior.
Who rose up from the dead. Thank you.
gives us, we can always have peace, knowing that this same Jesus that is recorded in the Bible is that same Jesus that we praise and serve today.
This same Jesus who walked in Galilee, well now this same Jesus who talked beside the sea, well now this same Jesus by faith I have been told, this same Jesus will save your soul.
Well now this same Jesus who heard the Hebrew children, heard the Hebrew children down in Egypt land. This same Jesus will lift your burden.
This same Jesus will take your hand. Well now this same Jesus who walked in Galilee. Well now this same Jesus who talked beside the sea. Well now this same Jesus by faith I have been told. This same Jesus will save your soul.
Well now this same Jesus who locked the lion's jaw, locked the lion's jaw down in Daniel's den. This same Jesus will lift your burdens.
This same Jesus will be your friend. Well now this same Jesus who walked in Galilee. Well now this same Jesus who talked beside the sea. Well now this same Jesus by faith I have been told. This same Jesus will save your soul. This same Jesus who walked in Galilee. This same Jesus who talked beside the sea. This same Jesus by faith I have been told. This same Jesus will save your soul. This same Jesus will save your soul. This same Jesus will save your soul.
It's always a game of fun on the same. I love the truth that it communicates. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. We serve the same God that was in the Old Testament and the New Testament. He's still with us today. And this same Jesus will save your soul. It's a great song. One thing I learned in high school, well, I guess just whenever I was younger, was just to trust God's will and be patient with what he's doing through me. I am from Kentucky, as like I said earlier, and basketball is a huge thing in Kentucky. I know football's a big deal in Texas, but I loved basketball. That was my thing. I played basketball all the time. I was in third or fourth grade, and I started dislocating my knees very badly. I got to where I couldn't play any sports, even run. And we went to a few doctors, got some x-rays, MRIs done, and I was born with no place for my kneecaps to sit, which is a very bad problem to have. And the doctors told me basically to get into golf and not be able to run or play the sports or anything that I enjoyed. And hearing that as a third and fourth grader was really heavy on me. So it was during this time that I was kind of, you know, seeking out Lord, you know, what do you want me to do? That I had the opportunity to go to music school and learn about the songs that we're singing for y'all tonight, learn how to sing, and where to sing, when to sing. I still don't know how to sing, but I act like it. But I did get to go and learn just all about our heritage, the hymns that we sing and everything, and I really grew closer to the Lord because of it. And after I got home from music school, I talked to a doctor, and he told me he was able to do a surgery on me, basically reconstruct both of my knees to where I could run and play basketball, do whatever again. And it wasn't that the Lord took my knees away from me. It was that he borrowed them and had me shift my focus onto what he wanted me to focus on, not basketball, but rather focus on him and preparing me for this ministry. And once I got my focus fixated on that, he gave me my knees back, and so I was not only blessed with the music, but I'm also blessed with the ability to run and do the things I love. So I really learned to be content with where the Lord has me.
The sound of love invites us to you come running. The shepherd's voice is in our hearts. We walk his way, the pastures of his presence. Find him the peace that grace imparts. He knows your name and speaks it to his Father. His thoughts are with you each moment of the day. He is no stranger to your hurt. His care, the shepherd knows your name.